Hey, so Sean, what is going on? I wrote a book. Wrote a book about die rolling in Python. And how to fix die roll errors that you encounter in games. Here's a random roll, 2 to 12. Some of you are thinking, oh no, that's wrong. Some of you are thinking, what? Roll a number from 2 to 12. But when it's a 2d6 roll, typically you add the two dice together. Let's see. Because otherwise you end up with this. Here's a 2 to 12 roll. But it's linear. It's like this happens a lot when you have a programmer who's familiar with d20s. So they'll do a roll from 1 to 20. But in a Traveler game, they see that the rolls are 2 to 12. And so they just type in 2 to 12, using the same kind of roll that a d20 would be. So you don't want this. You don't want an equal chance of rolling a 2 or a 12 or a 6 or a 7. You don't want that. No. Let's see. Do I still have it up here? So if I just change it. This was already preordained. I already had this set up for the video. So if I change the result from one roll to two different rolls added together, 2d6 rolls. So now if I run that, let's see, do I still have it open? Okay. So now it's got the bell curve it's supposed to have. I mean, these are to some people it's like, Driscoll, what difference does it make? At this point, what difference does it make? Well, it's kind of a big deal. Because if you're doing an encounter of some kind and you're using the charts from Traveler, typically you want to more of a chance of rolling encounters in the middle of the chart instead of rolling on the top or bottom listings of the chart. I mean, that's usually how things go, right? Okay, I can close that one. I can close this now, right? So I found this program on was it GitHub? I don't remember who did it. It's a couple years ago. I always go on GitHub to look at Traveler stuff people upload. And I was playing around with it, just it's been sitting on my hard drive for like 2 or 3 years without doing anything with it. And I'm getting ready to start deleting stuff that I don't need. And I came across this. And it runs kind of. It's not finished. Like the animal and it's a program that does encounters. Animal, patron, person, starship. It's not finished. Just like mine's not finished either. Get to it, Driscoll. Chop chop. So I have too many other things I'm doing. And writing up boring encounter table apps again for a different language, it's kind of tedious. So I can understand why these things are half-assed, half-finished. The glaring thing I notice is that it's using that rand thing. It's using that. And I specifically say, don't do this. You want to do this instead, Use a custom die roller. I happen to have written one. So to fix that, I have to go in here and say, what is it? From PyDice, that's my thing. Import role. So I'll leave the random one in there because I think this person's, I'm assuming this is a guy. I mean, what girl writes Traveler die rolling apps? I mean, I know who, but I won't say. I'm just going to add this extra one in here. So we got two kinds of randomizers. And then I can just change this from 2 to 12, make it a roll, make it a whole different function here. Put in 2d6 there. Done. Then copy, paste that into here. So both of them are doing it right. Because that will drive me to drink. If the reaction roll and the attack roll aren't using bell curves. So it's going to roll somewhere in this area. Instead of picking these equally, the amount of time, you know, the number of times, it's going to pick mostly in here. Like it's supposed to. And these are D66 tables. Those are a pain to do. What's going on here? You got a space there. Fix that. And then what is this? This looks like, I don't know what this is. Rumor matrix. Oh, I see. I don't know what the rumor matrix. This is from Classic. This person has rules for Traveler 77, Traveler 81, Traveler 82, and something else. Probably one of the other LBBs. So I'm not familiar with those. Okay. There is, okay, change this to 2. I'm correcting your stuff. There we go. At least the book I have. See here, they're doing the D66 thing here. I would love to just put in my D66 roller here, but then I'd have to fix this. I would have to go in here and fix all this stuff. Let's see. Maybe just a little thing. Just a little... For me to use someone's thing. Okay, here's another one. Some sort of Traveler Book 1. What was this? Chart 1 Patron. Looks like the rest of it's okay. I'm not seeing anything weird. I guess what I could do, I can just do a search. Just do a search, right? Do a search for 12. Oh, there's one. Let's fix that. Oh, there's one. Yeah, it's very important. Otherwise, you got pirate ships showing up all the time when they shouldn't be as common as regular ships. Let's see. What do we got here? I guess that's it, right? Yeah, you should only see 12s in the results of the roll and in the comments section. By randomly, is this written for a school project? This is probably for a school project. The teacher doesn't know any better. I know. Heaven forbid you should turn this in as a Python programming assignment to your teacher, and your teacher knows Traveler. F. What does it say? This function determines the specific ship class encountered by randomly generating a number between 2 to 12 inclusive and comparing it to the classic Traveler Starship encounter table. Inclusive. This has to be for a school project. Because that's what the teacher wants to see in the documentation. Inclusive. That means you're rolling the value rolled can be 2 to 12, not 3 to 11. You know, between these two numbers, you know, because in the 60s and 70s, you had to tell your teacher the numbers that it rolls, are they 2 to 12 or are they between the numbers 2 and 12? So you would say inclusive. Anyway, I just thought that was weird. I'm still seeing stuff like this in modern day programming. But again, I have my suspicions. I think the player who wrote this is just a D&D person and they're used to writing die rollers for a D20, which would make sense. You know, like, let's go back here. If this was a 1 to 20, that would be a D20 roll. Me, I would, let's see, let's go back. I would do, is it gonna let me? Nope. I would just do something like this. Roll D20. Boom. If this were a D&D game. Since it's not, it's 2D6. It's a huge ass difference. It's like a whole freaking die roll mechanic that's different. Okay, enough of this.